Pharmaceutical serialization, Wikipedia article audio. Pharmaceutical serialization is the tracking and tracing of the passage of prescription drugs through the supply chain from manufacturing to dispensing. This is generally accomplished through automated, electronic means, and is legally required in many countries. It involves such company practices as recording, authenticating, maintaining and sharing accurate records of items prior to dispatching. Pharmaceutical serialization uses track and trace technology, though the timings for implementation and the information required for a serialization program is dependent on local national laws and standards. Argentina. Rules and regulations are constantly evolving, so they require solutions that solve both current and future challenges. In addition, the production of pharmaceuticals and drugs follows the rules of international value-added chains and their complex structures. Prescription drugs are distributed throughout the world, which requires a highly complex supply chain, from the manufacturer through to the end customer. Drugs are produced, distributed, repacked and sold on by a series of organizations before the goods finally reach the patient. In addition to the challenge of international logistics, the different regulations of the countries concerned require sophisticated serialization solutions. Even in the longer term, we cannot expect the same or similar rules to apply to the international pharmaceuticals trade, and the continuing evolution of country-specific standards presents a challenge for serialization, its current techniques and its future development. As a simple example, differences between countries can be illustrated by the way the concept of the expiry date is expressed. In Europe, the date is expressed in the order day/month/year, whereas in the USA it is year/month/day. Prevailing standards in Europe and elsewhere differ considerably, and may undergo modification during implementation of serialization. So it is essential to ensure that any anomalies introduced by the legislative bodies of different countries are addressed, using lessons learned from practical experience. Crucially important for effective serialization is good communication between pharmaceutical companies and government agencies. Good communication ensures that information concerning new laws can be passed on promptly. The services of serialization solution providers and production line suppliers are in demand in this area as well, and they should develop solutions that are flexible enough to accommodate future changes. Brazil. In 2011, Argentina introduced a catalog of drugs covered by its National Drug Traceability Scheme, listing more than 3,000 drugs that require the placing of unique serial numbers and tamper-evident features on the secondary packaging. The drugs listed are recorded in real time in a central database managed by the National Administration of Drugs, Foods, Medical Devices of Argentina, Regulation 3683, which uses global location numbers to identify the various actors in the supply chain. The purpose of this program is to actively limit the use of illegal drugs. China. The 2009 Brazilian Federal Law 11.903 and subsequent regulations of the National Agency for Sanitary Surveillance in Brazil require that a 2D data matrix code be put on all secondary packaging. Under these provisions, manufacturers will be required to maintain a database of all transactions from manufacturing to dispensing, while distributors must report serialized transaction data to the manufacturer and keep a database of suppliers, medicine recipients, and packing companies. Europe. Data element: national number, expiration date, batch/lot number, serial number. United States. In 2008, China's State Food and Drug Administration made serialization mandatory for over 275 therapeutic classes of individual saleable product units by December 2015. The CFDA does not follow an international standard. Manufacturers may only register their products and obtain their serial numbers by applying to the China Product Identification, Authentication, and Tracking System. They must also implement a quality control system with an electronic drug monitoring system, a standardized documentation system, and barcodes to ensure pharmaceutical traceability. Companies importing drugs into China must designate a local pharmaceutical company or wholesaler as their electronic monitoring agent in the country. In addition to legislative reforms, China has increased enforcement efforts at the provincial and local levels. In 2013, the Chinese government coordinated joint special enforcement campaigns targeting counterfeit drugs. China regulations are currently on hold. In 2016, the European Medicines Agency adopted the Falsified Medicines Directive, which requires all pharmaceutical products sold in the EU to feature obligatory safety features. This directive is scheduled to launch in the first quarter of 2019. By February 9, 2019, all pharmaceutical companies will be required to connect their internal systems to the EU data repository, which contains the product master data and batch information. This will allow pharmacists and consumers to authenticate their medicines. The U.S. Drug Supply and Chain Security Act was enacted by Congress on November 26, 2013 and outlines requirements to build electronic systems that identify and trace prescription drugs distributed in the U.S. By November 27, 2023, full electronic track and trace capability will be required for all partners in the supply chain.